So it's been quite an exciting time for the elements recently. We had element 112 that got its name Copernicium. Oh, hang on, I'm sorry, we must stop. I've got the wrong time. So it's been an exciting month, couple of months for elements. We had element 112 named Copernicium, and now yesterday, or just the end of last week, it was announced that the synthesis of 114, element number 114, had been repeated. It was made about 10 years ago in a place called Dubna in Russia, rather to the north of Moscow. It was made like the other super heavy elements by fusing two nuclei, two atoms together. So in this case, they took an atom of plutonium, which has atomic number 94. So to get to 114, you need to add 20 to 94. So they used atoms of calcium, which has atomic number 20. And electrically charged atoms of calcium were accelerated to huge speed and banged into a target of plutonium. Now, the people who did the new work, which was in Berkeley in California, had their machine running for 8 days, banging away the calcium atoms into a target of plutonium oxide, and managed to observe two atoms of element 114. Just think for a moment, the tiniest grain of dust that you can see, like the dust on this table, will have hundreds of thousands of millions of atoms in it. So if you have one or two atoms, you cannot, not only you can't see it, but you can't tell anything about the properties of the elements or whatever. Now, the reason that people were trying to make element 114 is because there have been long-standing predictions by people who do the theory that perhaps element 114 might be much more stable than the other elements that have heavier than uranium. They imagined or suggested that there would be an island of stability. So you'd go through a lot of elements, 110, 111, 112, that would be very unstable. And then suddenly you get to 114, which would be much more stable. Unfortunately, it turns out in the experiments, it's not the case. They're only stable for a fraction of a second. And like the other heavy elements, they decay from a whole series of different elements which themselves can be detected. So you can see here the decay chain of element 112 here, and borium and a whole series of them, and soon there will be another decay chain for element 114. Now, the real importance of this experiment is that the original work in Russia has been repeated somewhere else. Now, nobody doubted that the Russian experiment was correct, but it is a general principle of science that nobody believes an experiment completely until it has been repeated. When my students do an experiment and get a good result, I congratulate them, and then I tell them to do it again just to make sure that it works. But of course, just because the same person does the same thing twice, they might be making the same mistake without realizing it. So if somebody else using completely different equipment in a completely different lab does the same experiment and gets the same result, then everybody will believe it. And so this is really quite an exciting event, because now element 114 has been really quite well established, and presumably soon people will be choosing a name. And it will be very interesting to see what they choose. And at this stage, I'm not quite sure what they might choose, but I hope they will be inspired by the German team that named element 112 and name it after somebody who's neither a Russian nor American, but who is a famous scientist who's inspired others.